हाय एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टूर ऑफ ड्यूटी और इंडियन आर्मीज़ 3 ईयर रिक्रूटमेंट. दिस वॉज देयर न्यूज़ बिकॉज इट वॉज सेड दैट इंडियन आर्मी इज़ कंसिडरिंग ए प्रपोजल टू अट्रैक्ट यंग वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल टू जॉइन द फोर्स फॉर अ 3 ईयर टेन्योर एज ऑफिसर्स एंड इन अदर रैंक फॉर ए वैरायटी ऑफ रोल्स. इट इज़ जस्ट ए प्रपोजल दैट दे आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू सर्विस ऑफ 3 ईयर. For this, various young working professional can join. So, as there was this proposal put forward, this was the news because of that. Okay, and this move was the reason for this move was mainly we can say that there was a resurgence of nationalism and patriotism in the country recently. That was one of the reason. And there is massive unemployment in the country, and the most important thing is that to tap the feeling of youth, the people who are young, who do not want to join the army as a profession but wish to experience the military life for a temporary duration. Okay, there will be people who really want to join the army, but as it is long duration, they will have to serve the army, that is about 14 years, they may step back. So if it is a short period of duration, sometimes they may opt. So if people are there who really want to serve the army or who really want to experience the military life for a temporary duration, they can opt for this. So that is why they have introduced such a kind of military service for 3 years. Okay, then current status of the recruitment is that army recruits young people under the name of short service commission, that is for 10 years, and they can extend up to 4 years also again. So it will in total become 14 years. So short service commission for 10 years and can extend up to 14 years. Then the recruitment process will be like this will be entirely a voluntary kind of engagement. The people can come for recruitment voluntarily, and the complete criteria they will have to fulfill. There will be no dilution in the selection criteria. And initially they are thinking that 100 officers and 1,000 men are being considered for the recruitment. This is just a test of recruitment. So as a test, they will be recruiting 100 officers and 1,000 men. Then there will be no restriction in their role, and they will be eligible to deploy as even as in combatant role. Okay, so based on their experience, they will not say that they are lacking in experience, so they will not be able to work in combatant roles. So there is no such kind of problem in this kind of recruitment. There will be no restriction in their role. They can be worked as in the combatant role also. So it will be same for both boys and girls, and they will be given 1 year training prior to their 3 year service. After completion of 1 year training period, they can continue or they can start their 3 year service. And as this 3 year service is introduced, it is definitely there will be some kind of benefits for that. Okay, so let us see what are the benefit of this 3 year service that the army personnel are for seeking. Okay, the first and foremost important benefit is that financial benefits. So as per the media reports, there are some financial benefits for this army, like from the induction of 1 person to the army, including all the expenses like pre-commission training, salary and other expenses. When he is released after 10 years, it will be a total of 5.12 crore will be the total expenditure. And if he is released after 14 years, including all the expenses like pre-commission training, salary and other expenses, it will be about 6.83 crore. So this is a huge amount. So if a similar cost for those released after 3 years, including training as well as their 3 year service, it will be just 80 lakhs to 85 lakhs. So comparing those in lakhs and crores, this will be more advisable. Okay, and if we are taking this in a large sum, this will take about 30% of the defense budget. Okay, and this is mainly increased after the one rank one pension scheme came into effect, because after this also included, this is coming or this is comprising about 30% of defense budget. So if this is they can able to, if they could able to reduce this expense into just 80 to 85 lakhs, this will be very helpful for the defense. Okay, so they can use the rest of the money for the modernization of the army. And another point is that this will be helpful for the young people in getting jobs in corporate as well as the government sector, because you know, once they finish their training, they'll be disciplined, confident, diligent and committed young man and woman. So it is, as per one survey, it is said that corporate houses will be more preferring employing individuals who have finished their training in the military rather than people who just finished their college. So this corporate sector will be preferring this trained military people or who finished their military training after their college rather than those person who just finished their college. So this will be helpful for the young people also. Then if you are comparing this with the compulsory military service, there are two points we have to note. That is, in compulsory military service, is mandatory. Here it is not like that, this is completely voluntary in nature. There are countries like Israel where the people or the citizens have to go a compulsory military service of 3 years. It is not like that, the recruitment or appearing for the recruitment is completely voluntary in nature, and there will be no dilution of selection criteria. In other countries where there is a compulsory military service is there, every citizen have to appear for this military service whether they are eligible or not. But here there will be strict selection criteria, based on that they will be recruited. Okay, so that is the comparison. And there are some problems also. So if you are considering their combat skills, the people who finish their service just for 3 years, if you are comparing their combat skills, experience and preparedness of this TOD cadre to go for war is in doubt. Okay, so when we are or when this doubt is arise, the officers, as per the opinion of the officers, they said that the performance of the officers and jawans with less than 3 years in service in Kargil war was really very good, and there was no doubt if that officers and jawans could do very or performed very well in that Kargil war, then there will be no doubt in this case of this 3 year service people who is finishing their training period. Okay, so what they are saying that already these people have performed well in the Kargil war, so they don't have any doubt in their performance. Okay, and what they are saying is that once they finish the same training as the regular officers of other rank, then their commitment, dedication and performance will be the best. Okay, there should not be any doubt in their performances when they are undergoing training of 1 year duration. They will be properly trained and they will be fit for doing all these kind of jobs. There is no need of any doubt in their performance or skill. Okay, and there are some challenges also, like one is that motivating these people and making them to opt this military service or 3 year military service is one challenge, and it will take time. And another point is that training them for the critical frontline combat deployment in 1 year period is another challenge. Anyway, these are the two challenges and all that things about this topic. That's all. Thank you.